RetroArch, there are several PS1 cores. You can use the same BIOS for all of those cores. For PCSX Rearmed, you don't need BIOS, but you can still use them for better compatibility. For Japanese games, you need the SCPH5500.bin BIOS file. For the US games, you need the 5501 and 5502 for European games. You have to find the BIOS file yourself on Google or other place, because I can't share them here for legal reasons. If you downloaded the folder version of RetroArch, which comes in a zip file, all you have to do is extract the folder, go to the system folder, and place your BIOS, and place your BIOS inside the system folder. Now let's open RetroArch and test to see if they're working. If you installed the Windows version, then you'll have to go to your local disk, and there should be a RetroArch folder here, and go inside that folder, and then go to system folder and place your BIOS inside the system folder. Now let's open up RetroArch and see if the BIOS are working. Now for the Steam version, you only have two PS1 cores, PCSX Rearmed and Beetle PSX. If you go to your RetroArch in your Steam library, click the right button, then go to Manage and Browse Local Files. This will open the RetroArch folder, Steam folder. Then go to System and place your BIOS inside. Now you can open RetroArch on Steam, so we can test the BIOS. You can check which type of BIOS any core needs by going to Load Core, load the core you want. Then go to Information, Core Information, Firmware, scroll down until you see Firmware, and you can see here all of the BIOS that you need. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and happy gaming.